Now today in class 12th, I will tell you about the astronomical telescope or refracting telescope. These are the two names of this optical instrument. So astronomical name is given because it is used to view the astronomical objects like the star, comets and the other so many celestial bodies. And the refracting name is given because this is based on the phenomena of refraction of the light. The optical. Instrument used to view astronomical objects like star. Galaxies and their satellites comets etc. is called astronomical telescope. Astronomical telescope. It is based upon the refraction light through lenses so it is named refracting telescope. Refracting telescope. So these are the two names given because of this one. The light coming from the distant objects is very small and very feeble, so we cannot view the astronomical object by naked eyes. The astronomical objects. Cannot be viewed by naked eyes. Because light coming from them is very feeble. So to view them, we need the optical instrument which could show them very clearly. So, telescope is used to view astronomical objects. Now, since the light coming from the distant objects or the astronomical objects is very small, so we need such a convex lens which have the very large aperture and having the large focal length. So this telescope contains two types of lenses, one the objective lens and second the eyepiece. Now this kind of telescope was first invented and made by the Galileo in 1609. The first telescope was invented and made by Galileo in 1609. So Galileo is the father of this telescope. Now this telescope has two lenses. The telescope has two convex lenses. Number one, objective lens, objective or field lens. And second is eyepiece. The objective lens has the aperture and fulfillment. Of objectiveness are larger than that of eyepiece. The distance between objective lens and eyepiece. Can be changed by means of rack and pinion arrangement. Rack and pinion arrangement. The image formed by objective lens is real and inverted. Real and inverted. With respect to object. The final image formed by eyepiece is virtual inverted and magnified with respect to object. With respect to object. So now let us have now this the objective lens is taken of large aperture and focal length so that this could collect more and more light from the distant object. So sometimes this is asked. The question is asked that why the objective lens in telescope is of large aperture. The aperture of object. objectiveness. Is taken large so that it could collect more light, could be collected. Collected to make bright image. The light coming from distant object is very feeble. Coming from distant object is very few. Very few. So now let us take the red diagram. Let this is the objective lens. L0. This is now the light rays coming like this from the distant object. They get focused at its focus. So this light ray will pass as such, and this light ray will be refracted. So they intersect each other at this point. This is the A, B, and this is now point F naught. The focal length of this lens, and here we have this is now eye lens or the eyepiece. Now this is the focal length of this eyepiece. Fe. So we are having the focal length here. This is now O'S. So now light ray from here that goes passes through this, and another light ray if we increase these light rays on the back side, then they will meet to one another at this point. This is now your A1 and B1. Here is somebody who is looking this object. This we take the eye. So this is the frontal image, A1B1. So this A1B1 with respect to this AB is virtual, the erected and the large one. And the object which is here, this is at the distant point, the its frontal image is A1 and B1, which is the virtual and this is what inverted and also the magnified. So thus the frontal image is from A1 and B1. So now let's, this is now point O here. This is now angle alpha. Then this is also the angle alpha. And this angle is beta. Beta. So this OA, this is now F0. This is now F0. And this is FE. FE. This is now your U for this lens. And this is now your B for eye lens. And this is now focal length. FE. Focal length. So notations are clear. This is the focal length of this objective lens. This is the focal length of this eyepiece. This is the distance u of this AB from this lens eyepiece, and this is now distance b, the distance of the image formed by the eyepiece. So now let us have the magnifying power. Magnifying power M equal to beta upon F. So now for beta we are adding this triangle. This is not so much. Beta equal to 10 beta, and this is your A1 B1 upon, this is now supposed by O'S. So this is now O'S A1, and alpha this is equal to 10 alpha, and this is equal to AB upon OA. OA. AB upon OA. This one. So now we use this in this equation, then this M becomes now this M is equal. This is now your A1 B1 upon O'S A1 upon AB into OA. So this is A1 B1 upon AB into OA upon O'S A1. This is now linear magnification. Linear magnification produced by this eyepiece. M into OA, this is now we are looking this OA, this is equal to F naught. So this we will write down this F naught upon O'S A1. O'S A1. O'S A1. This is now your V. So this is now V. Where M equal to A1 B1 upon AB. Linear magnification. Linear magnification. by IPs, and this M is equal to V upon U. So this M is equal to V upon U into F naught upon V. Now this V and V will cancel. So this is equal to F naught upon U. This is equal to capital N. This is not relation number one. Now we use the Lenz formula for IPs. Now this is 1 upon V minus 1 upon U is equal to 1 upon F. Now V and U both are negative. As we know that both are forming on the opposite to the incident to the direction of the incident ray. So this is now your minus 1 upon V plus 1 upon U equal to 1 upon F. 1 upon F, and this gives you 1 upon U equal to 1 upon V plus 1 upon F. So now you put this value in this equation 1. Using it in equation 1. The N is equal to F naught into 1 upon V plus 1 upon F. This is the real formula of magnifying power of the terrestrial telescope, of this astronomical telescope. So now there are two special cases. Special cases. Now in special cases what we have, that first if V equal to D, then M equal to F naught into 1 upon D plus 1 upon F. So now if we take the F common from this relation, then we can have this M equal to F naught upon F e into 1 plus F e upon D. So we can have this if V equal to infinity. So when we are having to so much, the length of the tube plus 1 upon F. So this M equal to F. F naught upon F A. This is now N. Now length of the tube. Length of tube L equal to F naught plus F A. The sum of both the four lengths, because the image AB that will be formed at the focus of both the lenses, the objective lens and that of the eyepiece. So now length of the tube that will be equal to F naught plus F A. Now sometimes question is asked that how will you increase the magnifying power of the astronomical object, astronomical telescope. For maximum magnifying power, what should be there? First is there is F naught and this F A. This must be like this one. F A must be more and F A should be less. And second, the funnel image should be found at the distance of distinct vision. The final image should be formed at least distance of distinct vision, that means D equal to 25 centimeter. Then this magnifying power will be maximum. If these conditions are satisfied, the focal length of the eyepiece of the objective lens is more than the focal length of the objective lens, the eyepiece, and that the fundal image is formed at the distance of distinct vision, then this is the mode. So this is the how to attain the maximum magnifying power of the astronomical telescope. Now, defects of astronomical telescope. Defects. Only I see that defects, this is sufficient. Defects. Now first defect is that it has the chromatic aberration. The lenses as chromatic aberration. So image is blurred. Second, since lenses are of spherical surfaces, made of spherical surfaces, so they have the spherical aberration. The lenses have spherical. Spherical aberration. And second, since the light is being transmitted through the lens, so the sum of the light is absorbed by the lenses. The light is absorbed by lenses. During refraction, तो क्योंकि इसमें refraction होता है तो इसमें कुछ light का ये absorb भी कर लेते हैं तो इस वजह से जो intensity of the image होती है that is less हो, so the image is not very clear and very intense. Because of these defects, the image is fed and blurred. And distorted. So because of this, the telescope has this a very serious defect, and this cannot be removed in case of this refracting telescope. Keeping this in mind, the Newton made a red telescope which is based on the reflection of light, and in that telescope, in place of the lens, the mirrors are employed. So these mirrors are free from spherical and the chromatic aberrations. Moreover, the light is reflected, so this is not absorbed by the mirror, so the image formed is bright. So that was made by Newton in 1690. So that I will tell you in the next video. So please watch this video completely and wait for the next video, the Newton's reflecting telescope. So thank you very much.